And homelessness has been an ongoing issue in the city, and it has only gotten worse since the outbreak of the coronavirus.
But a new place will soon open to help people in need get back on their feet. CBS 2's Jenna DeAngelis has a story.
This vacant building on East 91st Street between 1st and York is the future home for some of the city's most vulnerable, the homeless. This is what's to come. Seven floors, 88 beds, not a shelter, but a safe haven.
Rather than a very transient population, it's 88 people that we will work throughout the entire year to move into permanent houses.
Mark Jones is executive director of Goddard Riverside, which will operate the low-entry safe haven, offering special services.
So the psychiatric services, their medical services, there are counseling services.
Welcomed with open arms by Eastside Task Force for Homeless Outreach and Services, co-founded by City Council Member Kallos.
There's a lot of folks in the neighborhood. We have probably a dozen or so that everybody knows. They've got their spot, and this will help get all the homeless folks off the streets and into a room with a place to sleep and be safe, warm, and fed each night.
The Eastside Community Board voted overwhelmingly in support of the project this week, although some raised concerns about notice of it and safety, including the gymnastics school next door.
We don't need homeless people looking in the windows or hanging out here when these young girls are coming out late at night from their practice. We have Sacred Heart across the street with young people. We have Asphalt Green. They walk down this block.
Two local middle school students raised their voices to say,
I fully support the opening of the safe haven.
We're told it will have 24/7 security inside and on the street for about 12 hours a day.
Having a safe haven here, first of all, doesn't change the fact that there are homeless people in the neighborhood. What it adds and what it changes is the fact that those people now will be able to get the help that they need.
This safe haven isn't expected to open here until next January. Goddard Riverside wanted to announce this now to have a year to address any concerns and work with the community to move forward. On the Upper East Side, Jenna DeAngelis, CBS 2 News.
And notably, 46 people on the community board voted in support of the shelter, one opposed, and one abstained.